Yes, there we go. As we start this webinar, how to get to a six-figure salary even without a degree or master's. I want to say this. Now, I'm guessing for lots of you, this is probably not your first seminar or training to attend. The first thing I want to mention is that if you have failed to earn more money in the past, it is not your fault. There is a lot of information out there, and it can be confusing. Many times, that information overload keeps you from success. It's okay. If you're concerned, I want also to address, if you have been concerned in the past that you just can't succeed in employment, I want to put those fears to rest and let you know that you just need the right person to explain it to you. The society has perpetuated the message that you need to be an entrepreneur for you to be successful. Most people, as a matter of fact, are better off as employees. They are more satisfied and have higher productivity. The big corporations, the education system, and the government want you to think that you need the fancy college degrees to be successful. I'm here to tell you they are wrong. They have their reasons for wanting you to think that, but it is not true. If you have ever thought that the government and the education system want you to fail, you're probably right. They don't benefit from you succeeding. They want to keep you in need and in debt. The difference with us is that we actually care about your success, and truly, we want to see you living the life of your dreams. So that is what we are doing. That is why we are here. I know you have that dream job that you would want to get. It will give you the highest level of satisfaction and also utilize your potential fully. I want to show you how to get or to make that happen in this training session. So I'm really excited to have you here. So as we start, I just want to ask a very simple question. When you talk about a six-figure salary, what does it mean for you? What does it mean for you? So use the chat below. Let me know, what does a six-figure salary mean to you, so that I can be able to see if I'll be able, as in this session, you'll be able to get value out of it. So I want also to come to the chat, leave it in the chat. I'm already started. Just a minute. Yes, there is Franklin Ucheng from Embakasi. I can't see the video clearly. Oh, sorry, I'll see what I'll be able to do. I can see Chris Obweri saying, evening, tuning in from Meru, karibu sana. So in the chat, please leave, let me know, what does a six-figure salary mean to you? What does a six-figure salary mean to you? As we continue with the chat, I really appreciate we engaging and having a conversation. So moving on, I want to say this. This training is mainly focused to two types of people, and probably you are among these two types of people. Number one, a professional who feels that lack of a degree is the hindrance to their career progression. If you feel like because you don't have a degree or master's, this is the reason why you're stuck in your career, then this is the right training for you. And the second kind of person I want to, I'm looking forward to serve this evening, is that someone with or without a degree, you just feel stuck in your career. You are not progressing. Probably you have stayed in that job for 1, 2, 5, 10 years, and there's no hope, there's no future, there's no any opportunity for career progression. This session is for you. So I have one goal, or two. The first goal is to ensure that, to let you know that the only way to get a six-figure salary, even without a degree or master's, is acquiring what I call the badass pro skills. And I'll be sharing with you what these badass pro skills are. And the only way to acquire the badass pro skills is through a badass pro program. I'll talk more about the badass pro program as we proceed in this live broadcast. So I want to take a few minutes to just let you know who I am and how I've been able to grow to the point where I am right now. My name is Daniel Mutuku. I am the founder of Career Point Solutions, which started back in 2010. Yeah, we are turning 10 this year. And over the last 10 years, I have gathered a lot of insight of having worked as a recruiter, career advisor, personal and professional development coach. And that is what I'll be sharing with you this evening. I am also a certified digital marketer by Google. And among other groups that I'm a member of, I'm a very proud member of a group called LYP, the League of Young Professionals. On top of that, I am an author of 3 books. The first book I wrote is How to Easily Use Facebook for Profit. I also wrote a second book, which is Blueprint for Success, Guaranteed Steps to Achieving Anything. And I also wrote a book called Conquer the Year 2020. Make 2020 your best year ever. And you can get a free copy right away. So go to YouTube, just search Daniel Mutuku, subscribe to my channel, and the first video you'll be able to see with this image, just watch it. It's a few minutes, like a minute or so, giving you instruction on how you can be able to download this book for free. We might be 3 months or 3.5 months into the year, but that does not stop you to still plan for the year. With all the things that are happening around, I think this is the best time to reflect through how has the first quarter been and how can you tackle the rest of the year. So take a moment, go and check this book, of course, after this broadcast. I want to say, to debunk the fact that people don't believe that it is possible to get a six-figure salary, to get a good job and to be successful, even without a degree. And I did my research. These are just a few people that have risen to the high ranks and are paid very well, and they don't have a degree. Number one, we have the late Bob Colliboy. Bob Colliboy. Did you know that he didn't have even a degree, and he ended up being a CEO of the highly, I think, the best, most profitable company in Eastern Central Africa? Yes, Bob Colliboy did not have a degree, and yet he was successful. Maina Kageni, a very vocal media personality, he doesn't have a degree, and I'm sure he has a six-figure salary. We have Jalango, we have Churchill, and these are just among the few people here in Kenya that are very well known. They're celebrities, but there are other thousands of people in offices working and getting paid very well, even without degrees. And we will debug in this session, what is it that they were able to do to be able to get there? I will tell you my story on how I ended up talking about this. Number one, I cleared my schooling in 2009, and then I started my job search. And as any other person, of course, I used to send out a lot of applications. And it is said that for someone who's just out of college, it takes about 2 to 3 years to be able to secure their first job. I was lucky. It took me about 9 months for me to get my first job in 2010. And I can remember clearly how I was able to get this job. I was staying in Nakuru at that particular time. I used to run a small, it's called communication bureau or a computer services shop, where I would just, of course, type, do typesetting, printing, and small computer services. And we didn't have internet at that particular point at that shop. So every evening I would go to the next center where they had a cyber cafe, and I would apply for jobs. I had signed up for several job boards where they would send me some job alerts, just as we do at Career Point Solutions. If you sign up for job alerts, you'll be getting each and every time we have uploaded new jobs. And I used to apply randomly, and lucky enough, this time I was invited for an interview to come to Nairobi on a Tuesday at Consolidated Bank House in Nairobi, Koinange Street. And I was very excited. I can remember that time I woke up very early, and by around 6 a.m. I had already left Nakuru so that I can be in for the interview at exactly 8 a.m. And I can tell you, exactly 8 a.m., I was at Consolidated Bank House, third floor, Regiotech offices. So I got there at 8. I said hi to the personal assistant, to the manager who was coming to interview me. And we started waiting for the manager to come in. It took us about 1 hour, 2 hours. And at around 10, I think she felt that I'd waited for a very long time. So she decided to set up an interview room where we'll just interview. And as she was doing that, the boss, the manager, came in and he just said, oh, the young man is here. Come, tell him to follow me. So I followed him as we were getting into his office. He stood, turned around, looked at me. He was a big gentleman, tall, looked at me. Of course, I'm short. I looked up and he asked me one question with a lot of sensitivity. Can you teach? And I said, yes, I can teach. He looked at me again and said, are you sure you can teach? I looked straight into his eyes and I told him, yes, I have taught before and I can teach again. At that moment, he paused, called one of the secretaries who were out there. I remember her name was Linda. So he said, Dida, come in. So Linda comes in and he asked, Dida, do you know this gentleman? She said, no. He asked me, do you know Dinda? I was like, no, I don't know her. And I think the idea was he thought because we come from the same community, probably she's the one who has connected me to this job. And at that point, just say, Dinda, this young man from your community just got a job. And that is how I got my first job. And I can, when I deduced that situation, it was all about being confident and saying things with a lot of conviction and certainty that you can be able to do that kind of a job. I got the job. I was posted way in Siaya. We were setting up, it was a project called Computer for Schools project, where we were setting up labs, computer labs, teaching teachers how to use computers for learning, also teaching students the same, how to use computers and all that stuff. And it took me about 1.5 years working there, still applying, looking for other jobs. And come 2011, I came to learn about what I call now the Badass Pro Skills. After investigating all the different types of interviews that I've gone to, why I didn't manage to get through, sometimes asking for feedback from the interviewers, because come 2011, I got the job of my dreams. And I'm going to share with you how I was able to curate all the information and feedback and insight to be able to acquire this great job. And to say probably, you don't want to be a teacher, but the whole process of job application is like, you go out there, look for jobs, you send out as many applications as possible, you get invited for an interview. If the interviewers like you, you are given the job, probably not even your dream job, not the job that you're very passionate about. And just because you don't have a job, you take it. But with Badass Pro Skills, these are tried and tested techniques that will give you predictable results. They will let you know if you will get the job or not. And that is what I'm going to share with you. These skills did not only work for me, but they also worked to some of our clients that you have served. I want you to check. This is Alexander Mondwa, guy who sent us an email with a lot of appreciation saying that, hey, thank you. I attended a career presentation last time. This Monday, I was invited for a position of Alliance on Officer Kenya Airways, and Wednesday this week I got the job. I am the guy who asked several questions regarding the difference between an NGO and corporate CV. Thank you, I really benefited from that. So we used to have these physical talks. Yeah, we'll still continue having these talks even after this COVID-19, but now we are having this live broadcast. And these are gentlemen who came in, really talked about more about CVs, how to get a job, and he ended up securing a job at Kenya Airways. So this shows that it does not only work for me, it only also work to other for other people. So at this point, I want to pause and tell you, in this session, the next 30 minutes, 45 minutes or so, I'm going to share with you these two main secrets. Number one, how to triumph over qualified and experienced candidates. That is one of the questions that I always get. How do I get a job and there are other more qualified people, people who have more experience than me? How do I get that job? Today, I'm going to debug and give you the secret on how do you triumph over more qualified and experienced candidates. And number two, I will show you how do you negotiate a six-figure salary. It is all in the negotiation. So I will pause to check each and everyone who has joined us. I know some people came in. I will say, thank you very much. I want to see who has come in. Where are you watching us from? So I'll go to the chat. I'll just ask, please let me know where are you joining us from and I will be able to mention. So thank you very much. There's Franklin who said from Embakasi. I think I mentioned that. Then there's Coletta. Hey, good to see you. Watching you from Nairobi. Asante sana Coletta Wanjora. Karibu sana. I can see Redmi has raised your hand. If you have any question, please leave it also in the comment. There's a section for question and answer. Two more people raising their hand, please. There's Franklin, what a million shilling, something worth a million. Okay, I think you're trying to answer the question, what does a six-figure salary mean to you? Something worth a million. A million is seven figures, yeah? But I'm sure there are some salaries you get 2 months, you get to the million mark. Thank you very much. Ready Me, watching us from Githurai 44, I really appreciate. Let's just communicate and participate. I really appreciate that. More people raising their hands. Let me see who are these people who are raising their hand. Ready Me, there's Infinix X551. If you can change to your name, I really appreciate. Zakaria Jogona, welcome to the session. I really appreciate you coming in. Someone else who has joined us, there is Diana Marande. Thank you. Welcome to the session. Who else? Fred, Karibu Sana, Frederick Magaka, Santi, Linda Akoth, there's Maria Wanyonyi, welcome. I really appreciate Dr. Maria. There's Safina Florence, there's Sunday, there's Tunurish. Oh, I can't pronounce that. G, there's someone with a techno, Terry Muhuhi, Karibu Sana, Willy Geno. Thank you very much. Please feel free to ask your question. Let me know where you're watching it from and also tell me what does a six-figure salary mean to you. So I'll go now straight to continue with this. Number one, we are trying to talk about how do you triumph over candidates who are more qualified than you. Okay, there we go. So how do you triumph over more qualified candidates or experienced candidates than you? I want to give you a story. 2011, I got invited to an interview back here in Nairobi. Remember at that time I was working now in CIA as a computer tutor and technician. And I came to Nairobi, I was invited to an interview at an international school, this high-end international school. And I prepped myself, I used all the skills and the experience that I had from previous interviews and feedback that I got, and I prepped myself and I was ready to go for this interview. And I can remember almost word for word how that interview went. And when I left that interview, I felt like, yes, I have done my best. I will definitely, with no doubt, get that job. And for sure, the next day, I was called from the same company and they informed me, we are glad to let you know that we have offered you the job. That was the job of my dream. I was very excited and I knew I got that job basically because I was prepared and I was ready to get on to that job. Then that same evening, I got a call from the same company telling me, we had called you earlier to offer you the job, but unfortunately we are pulling back the offer. We are not offering you the job anymore. I got confused. I was like, why is that so? So the person on the other side, it was a lady, she explained to me that the job that we offered you was for one of their international schools, and it was for the first time that they were taking candidate class, they were having a candidate class to go and do computer studies at the IGCSE. And just because I didn't have any experience teaching IGCSE, I didn't have any experience or qualification in teaching IGCSE, as much as I imagined the best candidate, they would not offer me the job. The board could not agree to that. So they gave the job to the person who was the second position with a qualification and experience. And I think that goes to show that there are some things that you can do very deliberately, because there was someone who was more qualified, more experienced than me in that interview, but they didn't get the job offer at first. They got the job later, but they did get the job offer at first. I, who was not qualified, who didn't have any experience in that area, still went ahead and got that job. So how did I do it? It is all about how you present yourself as someone who is very confident, someone who is very articulate and with a lot of conviction that you can be able to do what is needed in that case. Now, I cannot put it in one sentence or a paragraph. I think I can just share with you. These are some of the people that I have been able to help through the same, and they're giving me feedback of the same level. Look at this, this is Brian. And he says, "Dear Daniel, yeah, I'm grateful for your services and would like to give you a feedback. The CV helped me get 5 interviews, 3 finance assistant position and 2 finance officer position. Lucky enough, I managed to secure a finance position job, which I'm starting in January. Attached, please find the job description to update my CV to the new position." So this is someone, it starts, of course, with a CV. How do you write a very compelling CV? Remember, it's about communication, and your CV is the first window through which an employer is able to see you. So how you are able to write the CV is very important. And this guy ended up getting so many job offers, and he got what he wanted. Again, here is Chep Kurui writing me an email telling me, "Hey, Daniel, thank you for always sharing how to answer questions in an interview. In the beginning of this year, I secured a job that I have been dreaming to be a registry officer, and now I am one. Thank you, and be blessed." Again, this is someone who ended up getting a job of their dreams. I left this, this January, today's 16th, about 3 months ago, four months ago, she got the job of her dreams. The next step, apart from CV, understanding how you conduct yourself in an interview, how you answer questions, is one of the key things, and I'm going to talk about it later in this session. So stick around and let me know, probably in the chat, let me know, what is the number one question that you get asked in an interview that you get stuck and you don't know how to answer? What is one of the toughest questions that you've gotten in an interview and you didn't know how to respond to? Please leave it in the chat and I'll be able to share with you how you can go about it. Again, Jane, a happy customer, saying, "Thank you guys for writing my CV in a professional way. I secured myself a job within a few months. I'm happy for the result. My current employer was pleased by my CV in such a way that I cannot explain. I went for 4 interviews and still emerged the best." Look at that. That goes, she just said it all. I can't explain anything. So I want, probably these are some of the questions that are going to your head. How long does it take for me to get there? I want to say this. This is a job market, and in the market, you're paid for 2 things. Number one, you're paid for bringing value into the market. And number two, you're paid for being valuable yourself, being valuable. It takes time to bring value to the market. It takes time to be valuable. But unfortunately, you're not paid for the time that it takes, but you're paid for the value. So I wouldn't be asking how long it will take, but I would rather concentrate on building value on myself. What about for office politics? I can assure you there's a way that you can be able to use office politics to your advantage to go up the management. How do I convince the management? This is actually even the wrong question. I tell my clients, you don't need to convince anyone anything. It is very hard to change someone's mind, but you can influence the decision. And there are techniques that you can use to influence the decision. The management will see actually you are the right candidate to take that new position, to take responsibility, more responsibility. Do I need to quit my job? No, you don't. Sometimes you have, but sometimes you don't. You can actually even be more, to thrive more in your current job. Sometimes you have to go, but I'll explain how you can be able even to thrive in your current position and to get the figures, the salary that you need. Is it possible for me? Yes, it is possible. We have just seen what has happened to Jay, what has happened to Chep Kurui, what happened to me, and it is possible to you too. So I want to say this with a lot of conviction and let you know that it is possible to triumph over other candidates who are more qualified and experienced than you. Before I go to the second thing about negotiating salaries, I've seen some people who have chatted and they have mentioned, I want to check probably is about the interviews. So there's Serafina Florence, Serafina watching from Adi River, Sabaki, Karibu Sana. There's Linda called, I'm watching from Nairobi, looking forward for the session. Then there's Abdizakir, not a tough one. I find unnecessary, not a tough, oh, you have a question that you, it's not a tough one, but you find it unnecessary. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? It is very necessary. It is not unnecessary. And understanding sometimes the intention behind the question is very important. This one to see, will you be still with them? Will you stick with them? Will you be someone who is valuable? Are you just using this position as a stepping stone for you to get to the next level? So there's a unique way that you can be able actually to answer that, Sandy. Yeah, one boy. Abdulzakir is saying, I was once guided by career point. I applied for position. There's the, okay, so applied for position at Gulf Africa Bank as a cashier and relationship officer, the first community respectively. Guess what? I was called for both and it was successful. I joined First Community Bank and then I was looking. Thank you very much, Abdulzakir, for your feedback. I think this is what everyone should be able to see. This is Abdulzakir saying, I was once guided by Career Point Solution in 2017. So we go way back there. He applied for two jobs at Gulf Africa Bank and also Community Relationship Officer at Community Bank. Guess what? He got both of the position. Thank you very much for that feedback. You used the same CV for a job at National Bank of Kenya and got it in 2019. Abdulzakir, I really appreciate if you can write this as an email, just as feedback, so that next time I will be showing this exact email so that people who are out there can actually get value out of this. Thank you very much. Is there any other question? I don't see any other question. Abdulzakir Haji, asante sana for your that testimonial. Send it as to me as an email. I really appreciate. Anyone, any question that you might be having, let me know. I want to see these two, Murushi G. Okay, I think I'd mentioned, welcome, Willing Eno. There's Terry Buhoki, James Kagenga, who has just joined us, and everyone. Okay, good. So let's move on to the second bit, and this is, how do you negotiate a six-figure salary? Number one, I did my research, and it is said that 84% of, this is a research that was done by JobVite. It is a recruiting company and a job board. And they say that 84% of salary negotiation always results to a higher pay. I think this is good news that if you go out there and try and negotiate for your salary, chances of you getting a higher salary is very high, 84%. But the question is, how comes not so many people get this salary increment? The same study showed that only 14% of employees negotiate salary at their current job. The interesting thing is that most people reserve salary negotiation when they go for an interview for another job, but very few people, only 14%, negotiate for their salary in their current job. Remember the question, do I need to quit my job? Again, no, you don't have to. You can still negotiate your salary where you are. So in this broadcast, I want to know, anyone here who has ever negotiated salary in their current position, not when you are being employed, like you have worked for a while, can you just raise your hand if you have ever tried to negotiate your salary in your current position? I can see Redmi Honey, Redmi 5, your hand was already up. Hannah Wamboy, there's Sunday Wamboy, there's Frederick Maganka. Oh, there are more people. There's Linda Akoth. How did it go? Did it end up into an increase in your salary? I really appreciate if I can get to know that in the chat. I can see Cecil Mugondo saying, yes, you have tried to negotiate. Linda Akoth, I think I'd mentioned that. How did it end up? So, as we wait for the responses, I want to say this. Anyone who is confident enough to try usually succeeds. If you're confident enough to go ahead and negotiate for your salary, you will succeed. Now, but there are some tips that I want to share with you on how you go ahead and negotiate for this salary. And before I do that, I want to check. Yes, how do I get my CV done properly? That is Frederick Maganka. Yes, we do free CV review. I'll talk about that later. Sunday Wamboy, I'm looking at the question, did you negotiate to your salary? One company, yes, one company, no. How did it go, Sunday, when you were negotiating your salary? Did it increase, did it not increase? So as you're doing your negotiation, I want to say this. Number one, you need to know the salary that you want before you get to the negotiation. Some people just go into a negotiation and say, yes, I want a higher salary. You ask them how much. They don't have a figure. It is important for you to have a figure of how much do you want. And this is based on your value. It is based on how much are you worth in terms of the value or the service that you're offering to this company. What is your worth? It shouldn't just be an arbitrary figure that you go ahead and say, I want 50,000, I want 100,000, I want 150. Based on what? It should be based on the value of what you are worth. And I'll share with you tools that you can be able to use to know what is your value. Tip number two, I would say this. It is important for you to make the company realize your value. You might be having you might be knowing your value, but even more important, does the company realize your value? Does it realize your meaningful contribution? Do they know your worthwhile while you're there? This is again very important. The reason why we have that figure, that 85%, is it 84? Yeah, of salary negotiation always successful. And 14, only 14% of people actually go ahead and negotiate. I did my research and I found out it is because of something called egocentric bias. And when I'm talking about knowing your meaningful contribution, it is also the same aspect. Now, this egocentric bias is the fact that we tend to be so much consumed with ourselves that we don't know what is really happening around us or with other people. And in a work environment, this is how it might play out. You might be a very hardworking employee. You bring in the results, you bring in the clients, you break the sales targets, you go over and above what is expected of you. And you're so much consumed in your own performance and you feel like it is important. I think your boss, your supervisor knows how hard you work. But unfortunately, they don't, because they're again so much consumed in their own affairs and their own endeavors, they actually don't see what you're doing. And you end up home feeling very frustrated that you work hard and no one really seems to see what you're doing, and they don't promote you, they don't give you any motivation. And this is because you're so much focused into yourself, but you really don't speak it out. It is important for you to speak it out. It is important to bring it to their awareness. And when you make the company realize your value, then you can be in a better position to negotiate for a higher salary, rather than assuming they already know the value and the contribution that you bring in. And thirdly, you need to use comparables to justify your salary. You don't just go with some figures, you need to have just comparables. Compare your job role, what is being paid in your industry. And there are so too many tools that we will share how you can be able to get to know these comparables. Now, to just bring this point home, I want to share with you these two testimonials. Number one, there's this gentleman called Julius. He wrote me an email and told me this Feb, yeah? Greetings this evening. I'm writing to appreciate your work. It is barely 2 months as I used your reviewed CV. I'm glad that I have landed 2 jobs. I have taken the one that I prefer. I am working towards completing my course, M&D. That is monitoring evaluation. Career Point Solutions, you're the best. Now, hold that in mind. Check out this second one. This is a guy called Lawrence. He wrote me an email telling me, I'm happy to inform you that after you guys reviewed my resume, I received 3 different calls for interviews within a span of 24 hours. Within a span of 1 week, I attended all the interviews and this was after a pregnant search for a job for 1 whole year. I only had a difficult task choosing which one to go for, but eventually I opted for one and politely and professionally declined the other two. I want to ask you, and I want you to be very genuine, and please be very open and answer in the chat. If you had 2 or more job offers and you had to pick one over the others, what is the one of the main criteria you will use to decide which job you go for? I will give you time. Please write in the comment. If you had two or more job offers, look at this. This is Julius, got two job offers and picked one. This is Lawrence, got three job offers and picked one. If it were you with two or more job offers, what would be the number one criteria, or what would be one of the key criteria that you use to decide which position to take? Leave it in the comment, or in the chat. I would like really, really very much to know that. And let us be open and genuine. No one is crucifying or victimizing the other. So Linda, yes, I got a pay rise. Oh, this is good. Linda Accord said, yes, I got a pay rise in my salary based on the work output I was producing. I was adding value. Thank you very much. So Linda, tell me, if you got two job offers or more, what would be the one of the criteria that you use to decide which one to pick and which one not to pick? And I will tell you without a doubt, salary is one of them. I choose the one that I'm most in line with my career. Thank you very much, Maria. So one of the jobs that is really in line with your career, that would be a good way to pick. Any other person, I'll be waiting to see that. But most of the people that have asked this same question, they have told me that one of the key things that they will use is to see which one pays better, which one has a better salary, which one has a better package in terms of benefit, working environment, and all these things, which are very key. Career line, that is Abdizakir Haji, thank you. So it is important to know that it is possible. People are getting two or three more job offers while you are applying for thousands of jobs and not getting response. What are they doing differently? It is important for you to know that. I can see someone who has posted some question. Can I get a job without papers? Yet I have experience. How do I write a CV without much education? Yes, you can be able. I will show you how you can be able to do that. Please send me your information. I will answer this. My email is my email, daniel@careerpoint.co.uk. I'll leave it in the comment. There's someone else with a question, how to explain the employment gap if I have been unemployed for over 4 years. Yes, you might be having a gap, but how you put it across in the CV is very important. And we have worked with so many of our clients who have had the same issue. And if, because by default, when you send your CV, you're being judged. They are asking the same questions and they will be filling up with their own things. And if you don't put it very clearly, you will mess up your chances of getting a job. So one boy, please send me your CV, yeah? I will be able to help you with that. Anonymous attendee, how to explain employment gap. I think that is the same thing. So I don't know if everyone can see the chat, but just write daniel@careerpoint.co.uk. I'll give in later the email. I think I'll just proceed first before I get to the question. So I want to say this again, it is possible to negotiate for a higher salary and get it. It is definitely possible to do that. Probably these are some of the questions that you're having in your head. How do I know I'm heading in the right direction? It is important for you to put tools and evaluation mechanism to check how you're progressing. We will be able to share with you some of the tools of tracking tools that will be able to show you and evaluate your progress, because it is very frustrating to spend 2-3 years doing something only to realize that you're going in the wrong direction. So there are tools that you can use to do that. How do I network with the right people? I want to say this. According to LinkedIn, 85% of the jobs are gotten through networking. And if these jobs are not advertised, and one of the biggest networking platforms is LinkedIn. So if you don't use the right network, if you don't have the right network, the right people, you might end up applying for jobs and never getting the right job. So it is very important for you to be able to network with the right people. At CareerPoint Solutions, we have a program, and I'll talk about it, where it is a pool of, it's a community of high-end individuals whereby you can come in and network with the right people. And you will see that these high-paid jobs, they are gotten through network. They are the 85% of the jobs that are gotten through network. So you need to know right people and network with the right people. What matters most is this experience of qualification. I would say neither. It is how, what value are you bringing in? You can be getting your value from your qualification, you can be getting your value from experience. So like that person who asked the question about they don't have real papers or education, but they have the experience, yes, that will still work for you and still get a good pay job. How do I balance work and personal life? I have been able to coach people who got to that position where they're getting a good paid job, but again, now they are unable to balance their personal life with it. Work because a lot of it, a lot of time and energy is demanded from you. But there's a way you can be able to balance, and I'll share that. Am I too young? Am I too old? It doesn't matter. I have seen people sabotaging themselves because they're just fresh graduates, and that is the word they use. I'm just a fresh graduate. How do I get a job? And I've seen, again, many people sabotaging themselves because they feel they're too old. They're like, I'm 40-something. How do I end up getting a job? I am 50. Will it work? Now, I want to share this. It's a gentleman. This, actually, this month, Sunday, Balishan sent me an email saying, hi, I recently landed my first consultancy job with Apio Kenya. After heeding to you, your well laid out, youthful, friendly advice. So I like this because I don't know his age, but probably he's much older than me. But still using my youthful advice, he got the job, the consultancy job. This is a very good organization. So age does not really matter. It is the value. If this gentleman got value from my youthful advice, who are you if you're old or young, not to take advantage of the same? How do I measure and track, evaluate my progress? I think I've talked about that being some tools that we use. How do I fix myself in succession plan? There's some companies which have that kind of succession plan. And it is very easy for you to squeeze yourself into that succession plan, even without them knowing. I talked about how do you influence, not convince. What are the qualities of a person worth six figures? There are certain qualities and attributes, and I'll talk about it shortly. These qualities are what embodied or are shown up by a badass pro, and I'll be talking about it shortly. How do I get started? I am going to share with you right now how you get started. And even right now, in this current situation that we are in this pandemic, I got this email, I think it was yesterday evening, and I took a screenshot. And this is some lady called Reha. And this is actually through WhatsApp. She sends me an WhatsApp message saying, hey, Daniel, I hope you are doing well. Sorry, I'm texting you this late, but I want to thank you so much for editing my CV. I have gotten a job despite this tough moment of COVID-19. Thank you so, thank you also for free training. You sacrifice a lot. May God bless you. You are so much. May God bless you so much and your team. My name is Rahab. And the project management course at CareerPoint. Yes, she was doing the project management. So yes, you can get started right now. Despite the situation that you're in, you can still be able to get a job. That is what I wanted to just communicate with that. So I have a question for you. If I show you exactly how you get your dream job, do you believe you can get a six-figure salary? Leave it in the chat, just say yes. If I show you exactly how to get your dream job, do you believe you can get to the six-figure salary? I'll be waiting to see some of your comments. So going slightly up here. Oh, Abdizakir, career line, I know a colleague who has no papers and is working with a corporate institution. Oh, good. So Abdizakir is saying, I know of a colleague who has no papers and is working for a corporate institution in Kenya with more than 22 years experience. Yes, it's only that we know the few celebrities or people who are in the media, but there are thousands of other people. Linda saying, I would go for a job that would enable me to grow in the industry and gain skills. Well, we are with a package in terms of benefits, insurance, salary, also consideration. Thank you. So you answer the question, if you got two or more jobs, how would you, what criteria would you use? Abizaki, he's great value to the organization. He really inspires me even though I have papers. Yeah, so you get inspired even for someone who doesn't have the papers. I really appreciate that. Frederick saying, are there home-based or remote jobs that could still add your six-figure salary? Yes, there are. Will I be able to earn a six-figure salary without experience? You will get there. It is not immediately, but you will still get there. Willing and I hope that is helpful. So I asked, if I show you exactly how to get a dream job, do you believe you can get to a six-figure salary? So Terry Muhuri says yes. James says yes. Hannah says yes. Probably not, but probably not. Okay. So there's Faith saying yes. Frederick Magak saying yes. Sarafina saying yes. Lisa saying yes. Okay, good. And Chris Omweri saying yes also. So I want to ask, because it is possible to get that, I want to ask for your permission. In the next 10 minutes or so, I want to ask, is it possible, is it okay for me to share with you then about this program called the Badass Pro Program that will actually enable you to get to that dream job and then end up getting to the six-figure salary? So is it okay for me to share with you about the Badass Pro Program? I'll take about 10 minutes or so and we'll be through. So just leave it in the chat. Just say yes or Badass Pro, yes, show us, tell us about the Badass Pro so that we can be able to proceed. I really appreciate that. I can see, yeah, more people chat again. Chris Omori saying yes. Linda Accord saying yes. Sarafina, yes. Okay, James also coming in saying yes. Oh, I'm reading the old ones, just a minute. Yes, Frederick, yes. Faith Chemutai saying yes. Terry, yes, give us more information. I appreciate that, Terry. James also Kenyaga. James Kenyaga. Okay, I think that is good enough. I'll proceed and talk to you about this Badass Pro program. So Badass, it's an acronym, and the Badass Pro is an individual who is bold, someone who is very courageous and is able to speak his mind out and very confidently communicate his point. Someone who is very authentic. I know there's that fake it till you make it, but if you fake it long enough, you will be realized. But someone who is very authentic, someone who is driven. You don't need anyone to keep on pushing you. So a Badass Pro is someone who is very driven, aggressive. You need to be aggressive. Things will not be brought to you. You need to grab them and take the bull by the horns. Someone who is skilled. Skills are very important. Skills are the basis of experience and qualification. But people sometimes confuse the two. But how you skill? You might have a lot of experience but not have any skills. Someone with a few years of experience with the right skills still gets the job. This is where you build up your value. And finally, someone who is self-assured. I can assure you, I am a Badass Pro. I define my own destiny. And I'm so happy to be here to share with you about this program called the Badass Pro. So this is what happens. So in the Badass Pro program, we have created a very robust program that is able to give you this qualities, this kind of personality. And there are three main things that we want to bring out of you. Someone who is very confident, aggressive, and competitive. And that is what will bring you on top of the cream. So today, if you decide to join the Badass Pro program, and I'll be giving you an opportunity to join, what is it that you will get in this program called the Badass Pro? Number one, you will get a six-week coaching program that is worth the value. I feel that it is worth, it's about 100,000. Now, in this six-week coaching program, you will be able to be taken through this. So week one, we'll talk about how do you get started, having the right, the winning mindset. Week two, we'll talk about, you will need to sit down and know how much are you worth, how much should you be paid right now? And then we'll look at how do you get to the next level paid after that six-figure salary. Week three, we will coach you and take you through building confidence and competence, because confidence plays a very big part. But again, competence also comes in. You can't be confident that if you're not competent, it is not a winning combination. Week four, we'll take you through mastering communication, influence, and networking. because communication is very key. It's not a matter of just talking or writing, but how do you communicate? How do you influence people? How do you take advantage of the network? Remember, I talked about 85% of the piping jobs are gotten through networks. Week 5, we'll look at tracking and evaluating your progress. Are you moving in the right direction? What are some of the things that you can use to rectify? And then week 6, we will sum it up with taking you the process of negotiating for a 6-figure salary specifically for you, based on your experience, based on your skills, based on your value, and how do you articulate your meaningful contribution. So it's a 6-week program. You will be able to get all this, and it is worth about 100,000. But that is not all. Once you join this program, on top of that, we will add one of our professional certification masterclasses, which is again at value of about 100,000. So on top of the 6 weeks coaching, you get this professional certification. We have 4 of them. You will decide which one do you pick. That is project management. You can decide to go for project monitoring and evaluation. You can either go for strategic management and leadership, or you can go for fundraising and resource mobilization. These are one of the key qualifications that will assure that once you get this kind of certification, getting a 6-figure salary is a no-brainer. Let me just give you a hint. Among the industry that you are paid much and there's a lot of flexible working hours is NGO and international organizations. And if you have either project management, project monitoring and evaluation, fundraising and resource mobilization, one of those certifications, getting a job with NGO, international organization, development jobs becomes super easy. And that is why we have added on top of the coaching, you get this certification. You will also realize even the corporate sector, for you to get that 6-figure salary, you need to end up in the leadership and the management position. That is why we are offering you strategic management and leadership certification. So you get to pick one of these courses. So at this point, the value is about 200,000 that you will get from the program. On top of that, we will not just let you go. We will do a professional CV for you. Again, remember, we have talked about the value of professional CV. And most people have CVs, and it's just a documentation of where you went to school, where you have worked, and a list of your referees. However, a professional CV is a document that you use to market yourself. And you need to be very sure, what is it that you're selling? It is your skills, your ability, your qualification, and your experience. That is what you're selling to the employers. And how you articulate it on a CV is very important. Now, it is said that it takes about 6 seconds for a recruiting manager to decide if they're going to read through your CV or not. And I want you to take a look at a guy. This is a guy called Daniel Mutuku, male, Kenyan, married, date of birth. And if you take about 6 seconds, and I want you to take also your CV, fold it into two, and whatever is on top of that CV, look at it for about 6 seconds and ask yourself, from this CV, what can this guy do? Unfortunately, there's nothing that this guy, we cannot articulate anything from this CV, what this person can do. And this is how most of our CVs are. Yeah. If we give this person a benefit of doubt and decide to read through their career objective, these are some of the common career objectives I have picked from so many CVs, probably even one of your CV. And it reads something like, I am seeking employment with a company where I can grow professionally and personally. Again, the hiring manager is asking, what can this person do? As a matter of fact, this statement is very selfish. You are telling the employer what you want to gain from them rather than what you will bring on board. Again, I've seen this statement. I'm seeking an opportunity where I can grow fully my skills for the success of, I can fully use my skills for the success of the organization. Again, good wording, but still not saying anything. I want to succeed in a stimulus, challenging environment that will provide me with advancement opportunity. Again, being selfish. I want to excel in the field with hard work, perseverance, and these are blank statements that have nothing unique about you. I can just copy it from your CV and put it on another person's CV and it won't make any difference. So it is important for you to know how to write a very good, compelling CV. On top of that, having gotten the 6-week coaching program, having gotten one of the certification masterclass, we will do the professional CV for you. And on top of that, we have sample cover letters. Remember, it is important for you to know how to write sample cover letters. So right now, the value that you're going to get out of this program is about 205,000 Kenya shillings. So when it comes to cover letter, it is a customized application letter for a position. This is just I want to give you a sample of how do you write a good cover letter. This is a job description I just picked for an accountant. And some of the roles I picked three: reviewing and establishing proper accounting systems, supporting budgeting and focusing activities, liaising with internal and external auditors. If you write a very good CV, a very good cover letter, somewhere in your cover letter, you should have a statement that reads something like, I have the ability to review and establish proper accounting system. In my previous employment at ABC, I was involved in liaising with internal and external auditors. You are using someone straight from the job description. You're using what we call action words, keywords. Time to talk about I have the ability. So you will get as many sample cover letters in your field as you would want. On top of that, the 6 weeks coaching program, the certification masterclass you pick, professional CV writing, sample cover letter, we will now put in a LinkedIn profile guide. Now, for those who don't know, LinkedIn is one of the biggest, is the biggest professional networking platform in the world. And many organizations are hiring through LinkedIn. International organizations, NGOs, they are no longer just advertising jobs. LinkedIn is a breathing CV. It is a CV that works for you even when you are asleep. I like that good CV you have that is in your flash disk in your computer that only sees the day of light when you are sending out application. Your LinkedIn profile is something that is out there and employers are seeking through your profile. And I've had so many clients who get called through LinkedIn and they are invited for an interview and they get the job. Sometimes that people go to your LinkedIn profile, they don't even think twice, they will not call you. So it is important for you to have a professional profile on LinkedIn. Some organization, for you to apply, you just press a button, it sends your profile there, and they are able to evaluate you from there. So it is important for you to optimize your LinkedIn profile. We will add that in the program. So up to now, the value is actually on top of the 6 weeks coaching, on top of the certification masterclass that you paid, on top of the sample cover letters, the CV writing, the LinkedIn profile guide, we'll do interview coaching. We will prepare you for that interview. And the value at this point is about 210,000. Of course, I'm not going to ask you to pay 210,000, but this is the kind of value that you will get out of this program. So I want to say this. When you are preparing for an interview, there are certain questions that you will be asked over and over. Like that person asked, you feel like the question is unnecessary. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? It is not unnecessary. It really talks more about you. One of the questions that you will always get when you go for an interview, tell us about yourself. This sets up the basis of the rest of the interview. 99.99% of the interviews you attend, this will be the first question. And how you answer it, as I say, will set up the pace for the rest of it. So you need to know how to answer it appropriately. So right now, the whole value of the program you will get is about 210,000 shillings in terms of value. But as I said, I will not charge you that. So I want to ask, are you ready to become a Barras Pro? If you're ready, just type it in the comments or in the chat and say, yes, I'm ready. Or just say, yes, you're ready to be a badass pro. As I look into the questions, I can see a question, how much do you charge for CV writing? I'll be talking about it. Hannah, Daniel at career.co.uk, kindly email me the tips on how to explain to employer gap. Yeah, I've gotten you. That is my email address. So send me an email. I'll be able to share with you that. So take note, drop me also an email. I'll tell you the charges. And yes, so I want to see who is ready to become a badass pro. Okay, let me just go my screen. Are you ready to become a badass pro? Yes, Remy says, yes, Nico Tayari. Frederick says, yes, I'm ready to be a badass pro. This is exciting. Yes, I'm ready. Hannah, Terry Mohu says, yes. Hannah is saying he's ready. Abdi Naziri is saying also he's ready. Cecil is ready. Mugondu, there's Hannah. Yes, please, I will, it will change my density. Thank you very much. I'm looking to give you, yes, give us more info. Okay. So if you're ready to become a badass pro, this is what I want to just let you know. If this program was just to get you to the six-figure salary, do you think it is worth that much? If the only thing it does, apart from all the additional, if it gets you to the six-figure salary, do you think it is worth? I really like to know what you think. So this, okay, I had two choices as I was trying to price for this program. Either I would go very cheap so that I can get as many people as possible, or I will just make it a slightly higher investment for everyone who gets into the program so that I can be able to dedicate my time and effort to guarantee your success. So out of the two choices, I decided, let me pick the second one. And for you guys who are here, I have a very special offer for you. For only $19,999, you will join the program. You will get a 6 weeks coaching program, one of the certification, professional CV writing, sample cover letter, LinkedIn profile guide, and interview coaching. And all you need to do is pay at least 50%, which is $9,999, and you will start off the program right away. So I am giving you an opportunity for all of those people who are in this live webinar to start off the Badass Pro program for only $19,999. And all you need to do is to pay at least 50%, $9,999, through the TIL number that is 715732. And this offer is only valid for this weekend until Sunday midnight. That will be on 19th midnight. After that, we'll start off the program on Monday. Please get on board as fast as you can. Hope that is, you'll be able to do that. But before we go, I want to say this. There is a 100% money guarantee. If you don't get all that we have said here, if you don't get this value on what we have shared, you'll get from the program. Within a month or so, we will give you back your money. If you don't get to a point where you get even invited for an interview, a position of actually securing a job, we will return your money back 100%. So there's no risk, there's no excuse for you not to take action. And I want to say this, there are two types of people, and I've seen this over and over, where I share this kind of information and you feel, yeah, that was a good idea, and you do nothing about it. Do you know what will happen to you? Nothing will happen. But those people who see an opportunity like this, and you say, this is great information, and you take action, these are the people who have seen ending up being successful in what they do. So my question to you, are you that person who does nothing, or are you that person who takes action and make things happen? Which type of person are you? Are you the person who takes action or not? I will let you answer that question for yourself. Again, from what I've seen and from research, the bad news is that you have 24 hours. I've already shared this information with you. But if you don't take any action in the next 24 hours, chances of you taking action, not only just signing up for the Badass Pro program, anything that I've talked about, if you don't take action, chances of you taking action later on is very low. So as I look at my clock, it is 8:33. By tomorrow, 8:33 p.m., if you will not have taken any action, chances of you taking action thereafter goes back to zero. Hope that is not you. So I talked about my email. Yeah, check out my email, daniel@careerpoint.co.ke. To get more information about this program, it's called Badass Pro Program. That go to careerpoint.co.ke/badass. I will just activate it after this session. So if you go right now, it will tell you the offer has expired. After this session, I will activate it and you will be able to get the information. However, I have a very special offer. For anyone who is an action taker, you will get 6 weeks coaching and you get all the four certifications, the CV writing, sample cover letter, LinkedIn, and interview coaching. Anyone who is right here live in this broadcast in the next 30 minutes, no, about 25 minutes, because we are closing at exactly 9, if you're able to make the 50% payment now, that is $9,999. If you make that payment right now, you will get all the program, the 6 weeks coaching. You will get all the four certifications. Remember, if you pay after this live webinar, you'll only get one. But if you're in here, you will get all the four certifications. you will get professional CV writing, sample cover letter, LinkedIn, and interview coaching. So these are the four certifications that you will get. Professional CV, that is project management, project monitoring and evaluation, strategic management and leadership, fundraising and resource mobilization. And on top of that, if you pay right now, you will get one of our branded t-shirts. These are some of the people who got it. Yes, you will get a badass proof t-shirt saying you are a badass. And on top of that, these, you will get a book, our notebook branded, I am a badass pro. So these are some of the people that have taken action previously. Here you can see this is Nancy all the way in Kitui, got her package. This is Eunice all the way in Bungoma, took action on a live webinar like this. She ended up with her great t-shirt branded, I'm a badass pro, and also ended up with a notebook. So I will be waiting to see who is ready to be a badass pro. I will check on the chat right now. So if you make that payment right away, just say yes. Or if you're in a position to send it or a chat, it might be difficult. We will give you the program right away. So I can see Willie, you know, saying yes, or James Kagenya saying yes, ready. Abdi Zakir saying, of course, it is worth it. So great, take action right now. So I can see some questions. Which institution will the courses come from? They are from Career Point Solutions, but it has been certified by NITA. So these are courses that have been certified by NITA. That is project management. Let me bring it back. Project management, monetary evaluation, strategic management and leadership, and fundraising. So they are certified by NITA. Thank you for your question. Francis Wangeshi saying, yes, you're ready. Take action right now. Let me take you to the screen. But before I go there, I want to say this. The best investment you can ever have is to invest in yourself. It is said for every shilling that you invest in yourself, you will have 30 shillings in return over time. That is 3,000% return on investment when you decide to invest in yourself. Tell me, where else will you get such kind of return on investment? Not the real estate, not the stock market right now, they are crashing, not anywhere else. It's only when you take time to, invest in yourself. I learned a very great skill. It's called the 10-10 rule from Brian Tracy. And the 10-10 rule is that you take about 10% of your salary, of your income. You normally take about 10% of your income and tithe it. Use it to help other people. But I put it to you, it is important for you to take another 10% and invest it in yourself. That is where you get the funds to invest in yourself and grow and get the highest level of investment. So I add you, it is important, take action and decide to invest in yourself. So there is the offer again. 6-week coaching, all the four certification courses, professional CV writing, sample cover letter, LinkedIn, interview coaching. And this is only available for people who take action during this live broadcast. As I go to answer the question, right now we have about 21 minutes remaining. I will be answering your question right now. So one of the question here, which is, I think I've answered that, Linda Akok, they are certified by NITA, which is the National Industrial Training Authority. Francis Wagesh is saying yes. Okay, let me check now the questions. Is there any question? Can I get a job without the papers? I think I saw that. How much? Yes, I think I've been able to. So if you have any question, let me know. I'll be able to hear to respond to you. If you're out there making the payment, let me know before we close up this live broadcast so that I can be able to sign you up right away. So, okay, having said that, I'm waiting for your question and I'm waiting for people who decide to take action right now and they get that. At the end of it, I think Linda Okop, this is one of the kind of a certificate that you'll be able to get, a project management certification. We'll put your name there. And of course, one of the key things is the writing, which will be talking about you, like Linda Okop, has been formally evaluated, assessed, for demonstration, so for demonstrated knowledge and skills to monitor and evaluate project. Use result-based management and has been awarded a certificate in project monitoring and evaluation. And it, of course, it will have a seal and they get a unique project monitoring and evaluation number. So I think that is mainly it. Again, I'm reminding you, get all the 4 certification courses, get the 6 weeks coaching, sample cover letter, LinkedIn interview, and all you have to do is to pay right now before it's 9, that is 9,999 through the till number. So you need to go to Lipa na M-Pesa, then pay for goods and services. This is a till number, 715732. It will basically show you career point solutions. Then we'll be able to proceed. I am open to answer any question that you might be having. Any, it might be concerning what I have shared this evening. It might be concerning career progression. It might be about interviews, questions that you have been asked, you didn't know how to answer. Might be something more specific about the Badass Pro program. Remember, this offer only lasts up to Sunday 19th, midnight. On Sunday, we close it up. Everyone that will have joined starts off come Monday morning, and we'll take you through the coaching, we'll take you through the certification courses, and we'll show you after the 6 weeks, you can actually stand and say, yes, I have gotten value. I can see my career progression. Irrespective of the current situation. With the current situation, it might look as if it is very hard, but it is not. Oh, I can see a question coming in here. Okay, I don't think, I think I've already answered. So thank you very much. I really appreciate. I'm seeing we're still there. Cecile Bukondu, what do you have any question? What would you like me to probably be able to assist you? Okay, no. PowerPoint that I had. Yeah, any question? If we don't have any question, I think I will just call it a day, because I want to be able to be out there and serve whoever needs to start off with the program. Okay, I can see Faye Chebu Tai say paid. Thank you very much. You get yourself, first of all, t-shirt. You get yourself the notebook, or it fell right down here. You get yourself, I really appreciate. Let me see if my colleague on the other side is able to, So Faye, thank you very much for taking action. You get all the 4 certification. You will get yourself your book, and you get yourself your t-shirt. Let me know where you're from, or where, which size of the t-shirt, so that we can be able to send it to you. I really appreciate you taking action, being the first one. I'll be waiting for the others as I answer any question that comes in. I also want to say this, yeah? You realize that it is all about your personality. It is all about how you talk, how confident you are in your skills and your competence. Because when you combine confidence, when you combine aggressiveness, when you combine competitiveness, there's nothing that you can't do. You go out there and say, this is what I'm good at. I will help you get from here to here. Understanding the organization's objective and how you can be able to assist them to go to the next level. You can be able to negotiate a salary of any amount as long as you understand the value of the money. Let me just ask, what is this money? What is money? By itself, money, this, if you are someone who doesn't know anything to do with math, will say this is just paper. Yes, it is paper. But what is the difference between this paper and the paper which is inside this book? It is the value that it represents. So this will represent value of about 1,000. And if I am going to buy something, I'll ask myself, am I willing to exchange the value that I'm getting here with this 1,000 shilling. So you find that the money represents value. And if, when you are now negotiating for salary, basically they are telling you the services that you're giving us, it is valued at this. They might be having a different way of judging the value, but instead of waiting for your organization to have a different scale to evaluate the value that you're bringing in, why not invest in yourself and become more valuable, such that if that organization does not appreciate the value that you're bringing in, then it is a matter of you showing your value somewhere else. Someone will appreciate it and they will pay it for what it is really, really worth. So it is a game of value. And let me tell you this, you know, money by itself, money regenerates. Money regenerates. What do I mean by that? In a normal state, you are paid at the end of the month. You have all the bills you need to pay. Sometimes you remain a few cash, what we call disposable cash. And most of the time we spend them on things that makes us feel good. And come end of the next month, some more money comes in. We pay our bills. We have some disposable cash. We go for a movie. We eat out one day or do some stuff like that. But at the end of it all, you realize that if you don't spend this extra cash, this disposable cash that you use to reinvest in yourself, you realize that this money that you keep on getting at the end of the month will remain the same. But unfortunately, your expenses, your bills will always be going up. And due to depreciation, sometimes that money value goes down. So instead of being happy or comfortable where you are, something that you can do deliberately is to decide, I'm going to add value to myself. I am going to be someone who is valuable in the marketplace. It might take some time, as I shared earlier, but it is the value that you bring to the market that you are paid for. I think having said that, I am waiting. Okay, I think I have seen a question here coming in. Is this recorded in case one wants to watch it later? Yes, it is recorded. And tomorrow I'll be able to, actually immediately after this, I will upload it on YouTube. And tomorrow I will send you a link where you can be able to watch it again. But again, the link might not be active for very long, because I want people who take action. I am not creating this video just for entertainment or for just you to have this information, but for you to take action. So probably it will be live up to Sunday, but sometimes I extend it. But yes, know that it is recorded, and hope you will watch it and get value of it and take action at least before Sunday 19th midnight. If you take action between after 9 today to that time, you'll be able to get all the courses. So Hannah, thank you very much for your question. I really appreciate. Anyone else with a question, I am here to serve you. I will still take more time. I have about 10 more minutes before I leave, but I want to thank you very much, Faith. I think, yes, this one has been answered. Okay. Oh, yeah. Any other question? So Hannah, don't forget to send me your CV so that I can show you how do you feel in the gap. Now, let me just maybe try and expound a little bit about that. Most people have the gap, and the gap come either naturally, because some people will have to leave the job, they got a baby, they decided to take care of their family. It might be under not very good circumstances, you get fired, you get retrenched, you get laid off because of the economic situation. Like right now, I know so many people don't know what to do, but I can assure you this, what you did with that time during that gap is the most important thing. I am sure you did not just sit in the house and waited for the next job, right, Hannah? Please let me know in the chat. But how do you put whatever you're doing? Some people end up running a business, but that is still valuable information. How you put it in a CV, it really matters and shows you the lessons that you learned in business. What are customer care service skills that you're able to get, negotiation skills, how to source for services, products. there are so many things that you get to know from business, from side hustles, something that looks very informal, but at the same time, how you present them on a CV becomes the game changer. So it is possible. Let me know, Hannah, what have you been doing for the time that you had that gap? I really want to know so that I can be able to respond to that. Faith, haven't yet known where you are, the size of your t-shirt, and so that if, because you see, like the people who ended up getting this stuff, we send it through G4S. It will get to you. If you are around Nairobi, you can come to offices. We open right now some period. There's some time that we open, sometimes we don't open. But if you're around Nairobi, we can communicate and we will bring it to you wherever you are. So I really appreciate you being there. When it comes to getting to that six-figure salary, it is all about, as I say, the value that you're bringing in. And you realize that certifications are more valuable sometimes than the degrees. I can assure you from, I have my own company. I sometimes even hire interns straight from college. They have great degrees. They have great, they're enthusiastic. They have the energy. But tell them to do something. They cannot articulate any hands-on skills they got from the institution to enable them work where they are. So you find that they have good papers, but they don't have the skills. I have had some people, and this is one of the biggest mistakes I've seen. Someone has finished their degree, for example. They look for a job for a year or two. They don't get a job. So what do they do? I think they need people with masters. They go back to school, spend another 2 years, finish their masters. They come back. They are looking for a job. They won't get any job. It's very difficult sometimes. If you have so many qualifications and no experience, not trying to get at an entry level, it becomes very challenging. So sometimes it is the certification, it is the skills, it is the hands-on things that you can be able to do in the market that will really, really assist you. Alright, thank you very much. I really appreciate everyone. I don't think there's any other question. I have finished up. So any last comment, if you found this valuable, let me know in the chat. Say thank you. And we will close it up in the next 8 minutes or so. So I can still see we have some people who are on board. What did you find most valuable? What action are you going to take in the next 24 hours? I really appreciate getting to know that. I can see Hannah, we're still here. Sunday Wamboi, we're still here. Agatha Muguna, you joined us. Thank you. What have you learned from this session? What are you taking home? I really appreciate if you leave it in the comment. I can see we have Cecile Mugondu, you're still there. Give me a last parting shot. What value have you gotten? Because again, if I just spent all the 1.5 hours just talking and you didn't get any value, it wouldn't make much sense. Christine Omweri, you're the one who was in Meru. Let me know, what value did you get out of this session? Leave it in the chat right now. Coleta Wamjora, Santi Sana for being with us for the last 1.5 hours. What value have you gotten? What action are you going to take at least in the next 24 hours? I want to know that. I want to put you on task so that we did not just entertain, you. I want to see that actually I give you value. Who else? Diana Marade. Leave a comment. Let me know what you got from the session. Faith Chemutai, thank you. You are a star. You're the people that I really appreciate. You took action. There's Frederick Magaga. What? Then there's James Kenyaga. There's Linda Accord, Redemi, Serafina Florence. There's someone with a Techno K9. There's Terry Muhohi, William Geno, and there's Zachary Njuguna. I'm waiting for your chat to be able to close this session. And again, I will say this as I finish up. If you take action right away. Some people are saying, so Chris always saying, thank you for the session. I really appreciate Chris from Embu, Meru or Embu, you said earlier, I really appreciate, thank you. There is Hannah Wamboi saying, it has been quite an eye-opener session. Asante Sana Hannah Wamboi, I appreciate, drop me an email as we talked. There is Chris Oboy saying, I have learned skills build up your value. Yes, that is very correct. I can see Frederick Gakka saying it's very eye-opening. Thank you. I appreciate. Remedy saying, "Let me. I have learned that the best investment is on me and the 10-10 rule." I think that is one of the key things. If you can forget everything else, invest in yourself. I started this process of investing myself, I think 2015. And since then, I've never stopped. I always take back money. I am very intentional. I'll give you one of my goals this year. And I have one of my accountability partner in this group. One of my goals is that I will spend about 100,000 on my personal development this year. And I have already been spending. I've attended online courses. I have bought books. I have gotten into some courses and even time. So when you decide to invest in yourself, you're just building value. And guess what? When you move from company A to company B, you don't say, oh, I got this here, you leave it there. You move along with that value. So I think that is a very valuable lesson that you have learned, Redemy. Investing in yourself and taking the 10-10 rule. Willing Eno, thank you. I appreciate Terrible who he says, I have learned that we can negotiate salaries in our current jobs. People say you should not negotiate since your work should show your value. Yeah, always negotiate. If you wait for people to see the value to them or to boost your salary, you will wait forever. But again, how you go to negotiate is also very important. I remember the last time I did a broadcast like this, someone asked, what if they threaten to fire you if you ask for it? It is how you ask for it. If you're asking it from this, based on the value that you're bringing in. If you're asking for a raise based on value, it is easier to negotiate rather than say, I've been here for the last 5 years. So what? Doesn't matter. So that is a good take, Terry. Then Hannah on boy, investing in myself is one of my takeaways. Yeah, that is great. I think I cannot overemphasize. We have like 3 more minutes and I'm giving you the last chance. And the fact that we're learning about investing in ourselves, I think this is one of the greatest opportunities for you to invest in yourself. Taking up the Badass Pro program is an investment in yourself. And investing $19,999, it will give you, it will have a return 3,000% over time. I can assure you, by the end of this year, if you don't end up getting that 6-figure salary, even if it is on the bottom bit of it, of them all, a 6-figure salary starts from 100,000 all the way to 999,999, just 1 shilling away from a million. If you get the bottom bit, let's say 100,000, that is already 5 times more what you have paid for the program. So even if you finish the 6 weeks coaching, and the only thing is you get a 6-figure salary, 100,000 in terms of salary, it will only have taken you a month to recoup 5 times the investment that you have put in yourself. So for those who are live right now, you get a 6 weeks coaching, the 4 certification, if you pay right now, just like Faith, I'm waiting to see who else. I think the person on the other side will be telling me who has paid. You get a professional CV writing service, you get sample cover letters, you get a LinkedIn profile guide. Remember, we have said the LinkedIn profile is a living CV. How do you take advantage of that? And the other side, you also get interview coaching. How you prepare yourself for an interview? Because now, let me tell you, the moment you've been invited for an interview, you have halfway won that job. It is now you yourself going to that interview and spoiling it up. For them to see that actually the person we saw on the CV is not the same as the person you are in real life. So it is important to have that personality, which is likable. By the way, it's all about how likable are you when it comes to the interview. But I don't want to get into much details about that, but I really appreciate you being there. Likeability. People are much willing to work with people they like than people they don't like and are more qualified and have the experience. That is a secret. That is how I was able to secure a job, even when I had some people who were more qualified than me. I played them. I showed them how likable I am. I ended up being the best candidate, but I can give you more details after that. So interview coaching. And the final words are coming from Zachary Njogona. I really feel a badass. Thank you for the session. Become a badass. I'm giving you up to Sunday. I'm a badass pro. I define my own destiny. That is the message. I define my own destiny. Don't wait for other people to define your destiny. Thank you very much. I appreciate that has been my time. I'll see you when we start off the program on Monday 20th, helping you become a badass.